Hey guys, Skippy3 here again. Welcome back to episode 3. So first off guys, I do want to apologize about the sound levels in the last Let's Play video. What happened was I recorded the video and then there was an audio glitch in it, and it made it sound absolutely horrible. So it took me a long time to edit my voice and lower the volume of the game sound because I recorded both together, and it was a horrible problem. It took me forever. I know it was hard to hear some of the sounds. Hopefully we don't encounter this in this episode. If we do, I once again apologize. I've recorded this before it's happened. But let's cross our fingers and we don't get any audio glitches. So the last episode, we ended in this new city. Above ground, I'm hiding up on the rooftop at night. Now, we did go for a wander away from my other city here. As you see, my home base is actually over here. I'm setting up a new one over here. I gotta actually mark it because there's a water source. There's a mansion right beside me. If you guys see, there's a pool right there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and put a waypoint on this area. Now, I actually haven't... I haven't put a waypoint on console yet, so this is a learning experience for me. Oh, there we go. Okay, so if you press triangle, you can actually put a quick waypoint there. There you go. So now I have another waypoint on my map so I can find my way back to my second base. Now what I'm going to do today, I'm not going to continue exploring the city because it is day 11. I have 3 days to prepare for the day 14 horde at my other base. I'm going to take that one on there. So what I'm going to do in this episode is we are going to go ahead and I am actually going to cut back across this grassy area, this area right here, just to see if I can find a good place to put my permabase, because I'll be putting in a nice large permabase in between these two areas here, so that I can loot these towns and do some more exploring in the area. I'm not actually even close to the hub, but with these two cities, that's good enough for me. So what we're gonna do here, guys, is I know it's nighttime. Like I said, I'm doing this as a Walking Dead playthrough. I have zombies jacked, zombies spawning jacked up, and zombies always walk. But other than that, it's on the classic zombie set. I do like running zombies. I know I've said that before, but this playthrough's a Walking Dead playthrough, so of course the zombies aren't gonna run at night because they don't run at night on the Walking Dead. So that's how it is. So what I'm gonna do, guys, is we're gonna head out and we're gonna start a journey across that area. Now it's gonna take me a while to get back, so what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually go ahead and start heading out. I'm gonna cut out a lot of this because it's literally just gonna be straight out running. I'm not gonna be taking on zombies. I'm not gonna be doing much, but if I do run into something interesting, I'll definitely cut that in. But next time I see you guys, we should be back at my regular base here. I got a lot of work to do, so I will see you guys in a few seconds. Alright guys, so I'm running through here and it is nighttime, but I think I found the perfect area for my permabase. This area here is really hilly. I'm in the lowest area of it. It's like a little bit of a valley. So what I want to do is build my base down low, because that way zombies, if I'm underground, zombies can't dig their way to me by going through the side of a hill. Like, let's say if I dug up there and I went underground, they could actually dig through the side of this hill to get to me. So my basic concept is a nice low area where I can see the hillsides all around me. Now, of course, I think I'm going to have to modify this area a little bit more to make it a little more useful, but this looks like a great area to do this in. And look at that, it's morning time. So what I'm gonna do here is mark this on my map so that I know where it is. Let's drop another waypoint here. Oh, look at that, it's right at an end of a trail too. Well, is this area ever hilly? Yeah, this is a perfect area. So I actually don't even really need to mark this because I know where it is now. It's at this end of this trail. But I'm going to save this waypoint as a... let's save it as a castle. I'm going to put my castle here. Cool. Okay, and off I go, guys. I'll see you once I reach my home base again. Hey, guys. So we are back at our base, and... here it is. This is our day 7 horde base. We still got lots of spikes out. What I have to do for the day 14 horde, because I wasn't going to invest this much time or effort into it, because I figured I'd be making a permabase by day 14. But what I'm going to do here is we have to protect it against spiders. The last episode I didn't because it was a waste of iron to do that. Frames kind of work, but they're easily bashed through, so I don't use them. So what we have to do here is put a ring of iron bars all around this edge. So I, of course, have to get my forge here going. And what I need to do, too, is try to concentrate on getting my steel smithing up so that I can get some better tools to use because, I'm kind of hurting in that part here. I don't have, I have low iron tools and it's just, it's not doing it for me here. So what I'm going to do is pop in the items I have right now. All my iron and whatnot. Get this sucker going. And we'll make some iron bars here. Now, I don't know how many I actually need. I can make up to 139. You know what? I'm going to make... Let's go down to 80. I really wish there was a button you can press to make it like go 5 or 10 or 50 items at a time. I'm sure they're going to add this in the future here, though. Okay, so let's get 80 of these going. I know that's going to be more than enough, but we can always use them in the future in another build as well, too. So I'm not too worried about that. What else do we got at a regular base? Ah, yes, meats. I gotta start doing some cooking as well here, too. Just make some bacon and eggs. Tasty. Oh, and of course, throw some fuel into the fire. 6 bacon and eggs coming right up. And we even have some extra eggs, that's always good news. So I'm probably hungry because I ran back and forth, so let's grab some food up here. Looks like I got a wandering horde outside of the base as well. I'm going to have to take care of those guys pretty soon. Let's see what's going on. And once again, guys, I hope you can hear that sound. Oh yeah, we got a wandering horde coming in my direction here. Looks like they're taking care of themselves, so that's alright. I have some arrows that I need to make. So I'm going to make those up. They're in the forge here. There we are. Grabbed a whole bunch of arrows on my way back here as well. So I'm going to do storage, get some of the stuff out of my inventory here that I don't need, like animal hide. Let's wear this because it's daytime and I want to keep myself cooler. And it looks like I need a second storage here. This is definitely not going to do. So since this is not a permabase, I'm going to just go ahead and start filling up the storage as well. Let's get those gas barrels in there. Leather, of course, when I need to make that bow. My paper, animal hide, have a ton of that. What else do we have in here? Some grain alcohol, I don't need that. The water we're good on because I did find that one water source at the pool in the last episode. Feathers. Oh yeah, I gotta make some more feathers here. Let's get that going. A lot of people say the UI and everything is incredibly clunky in this game, but I don't get it. I actually prefer playing on a controller than I do keyboard and mouse. I find it much quicker. Other than the fact that you can't search recipes. But other than that, I mean, it's not that really that big of a deal at all. So did this horde end up killing themselves? Yeah, I just got one crawler left here. So I gotta go down there and do some looting, take care of these guys. So let's head down here. I want to get the... I don't want my spikes to kill this guy because I want credit for it. I just wasted 3. Ah, whatever. Let's go down and loot him. Let's go take care of business here. And then by that time, I'm going to go out and search for some iron. Take a look at my skills here before I do that. So many things to do. I can't keep up with it here. Okay, so I wanted steel smithing. So I'm going to go to here. What did I need? Oh, yes. Construction tools level 40. I'm only at level 18. Ooh, ouch. Yeah, I got so much building to do. That's why I was using my tools. Okay, cool. So since I haven't done a lot of building, I need to get that tool skill up so I can do my steel smithing because I really want some steel tools. These iron ones are okay, but they're nothing compared to the steel. I love doing like a one-hit thing. It's so much fun. Let's go do some looting here, and I guess I'm going to go out and do some gathering and try to level up that a construction tool skill by using a construction tool to do the gathering. It'll be a little bit slower, but I really need to get that skill up. What do we got here? Just junk. Some water. May as well take that. Some more water. And where is this one here? Really hate that sound too when they explode. It sounds really weird. Throws me off every once in a while. If I don't kill myself on the spikes again. These painkillers are really useful. Oh, there's an airdrop. I know a lot of you have been asking me to do a tutorial on the airdrop. I don't know how to do a tutorial on the airdrop. You see it, you run towards it, and you go and get it. That's basically it. It'd be like a 2-second video. So if you did ask for one, guys, let me know down in the comments exactly what you meant. I'm not really entirely sure. Oh, looks like there's two airdrops in that direction. Nice. But also too, guys, I did recently release a channel update video. And I asked you guys, you know, what other games do you want to see me play? Because obviously there's more games than just 7 Days to Die out there. And I don't want to become one of those channels that are entirely stuck on one game. Because once that game dies off, so does the channel. And I really don't want to go in that direction. So we're going to try to avoid that if I can find these airdrops. I wonder where they landed. We might not be able to find these. Whoa. there's a bear over there. Stay away from that sucker. Okay, so it looks like there is no airdrops in here. I don't know where they landed. They could have landed somewhere stupid, like on top of something. It's really, really hard to tell, especially when that airdrop indicator disappears. You're pretty much on your own. What I find after a while is I find them while out and scavenging after a while. So I don't tend to go after them right away because of that reason. But I needed to go out and scavenge anyway. So this is a good area to do it in. Especially too because of all these coolers and stuff. There's always food and stuff you can find in them. So I'm going to hit up this area looking for stuff. Let's search our toilet here. Ooh, handgun. Nice. Always useful to find in those. So I'm going to be going and hitting these rocks here as well, too, to get some iron. But to continue on the channel update video, I want to thank you guys, too, for all your comments and your replies. There was a lot of ARK. I'm not really going to do ARK, guys. I like games that you can build in. And I know ARK has building. But it's just, it's not the same. 1 second here. I'm going to try to take out this nurse. Oh, may as well reload the gun first. And Mr. Head. Horrible. Thank God I don't have to defend myself in real life. I'd be in real big trouble. There we go. Lay it down. Now, I do like the bow, but the thing about the bow is it's very... It's very hard to level. The leveling for the bow is very slow, and it's really hard to get XP that way, especially for leveling your skills. Like, I do love the bow, but I mean, the handgun and any other gun levels way faster in skill than the bow does. I hope they do balance that out in the long run. I don't know if that's on purpose or not, or why it is that way, but I'm thinking it's just a simple imbalance and overlook in the gameplay. Because it wouldn't make sense why your bow skills increase incredibly slower than your weapon skills increase. I don't know. To me, that doesn't make any sense. The other games I've seen some replies of were Stranded... getting back to the ARK thing. ARK is cool. I did play ARK. It's fun to tame animals and do a little bit of PvP. But honestly, in my opinion, the building is horrid. I really don't like doing the buildings in those games. For me, in the survival game, what holds me in the game after I've reached, let's say, max level or along those lines, is the building. And ARK, I get bored of quickly because the building is very static. It's got that place a base down, put your walls on the base. You can't modify the ground. It's not voxelized. I like voxelized games, so I don't think I'm going to be doing any ARK playthrough, guys. I'm very sorry. Same goes for Stranded Deep. It's a pretty game, but once again, it's got that whole static place a base down. And you can only place stuff. You know, it's hard to build big things. You can be really creative and build some stuff. But, I mean, you're still very limited, right? I do like being able to place blocks and whatnot. I liked Reign of Kings for that reason as well, too, but it's just too bad the developer, Cold Hatch, bailed on the game. I'll never trust those guys again. But yeah, Stranded Deep looks alright. I checked it out. It looks like it has that boring building thing. I do like the forest, although it has the same building style. It seems to be trying to do it differently than the other games, so I might do that. There's another game as well, too, called Miscreated. It's absolutely beautiful looking. If you guys haven't seen Miscreated yet, go and look it up. It's in development. They're a little slow with it, but I mean, I'm impressed with the direction they've been heading, and it looks just absolutely gorgeous. So I'd recommend checking out Miscreated 2. I'm definitely going to be doing a Let's Play on Miscreated. Now, that game, too, doesn't have a lot of content, so it'll be a short Let's Play series, because they just added things like storage in that game. There we go. Nice. So I'm going to go over and steal this guy's meat because I'm hungry. Miscreated looks pretty cool, so I'm going to be doing a Let's Play of that. I'm definitely going to be doing a Let's Play Fortress Craft. That game's amazing. It's all about automation. It's kind of like Minecraft FTL, but it's a much more smoothed out version because it's not a mod and it's a standalone. It's beautifully done. I love it. And there's a butt ton of content. It'd be so easy to do a Let's Play on. I played a lot in a single player game to get used to the game. There's been a huge content update to it that I haven't been able to get to yet, so I'm really anxious about that, and I can't wait to show you guys that game as well. And I mean, feel free, guys, in this episode to drop a suggestion for what kind of game you want to see. I'm going to make a new stone axe. This one's almost broken. It's just not doing it for me now. But yeah, if you guys have any suggestions and anything too as well, I'm always open to them. Let's craft up one of these. So hopefully by the time I get back with some more supplies here, some more iron, that forge will be up and running. I also need to increase my tool skills here, or my tool crafting. Ah, nice, I'm level 21. Haha, beautiful. I also got to get my tool crafting up here too. I'm level 419 is not bad, but it's not level 600. When you have like level 600 and minor 69er, you walk up to these things and one hit them. You can take down a tree in one or two swings. It's beautiful. I love it. But I'm going to continue gathering up supplies here. What do I need? I have iron. I also need wood too, apparently. So I'm going to be grabbing up some wood here next, because I have a lot of iron and stone. So that's good enough for now. I think I'm going to throw some more spikes out around my base, especially for that day 14 horn. I might actually run the spikes right to the base and fill up the basement of the, or the first floor of the base with spikes. So that way, if they do make it through, they just kill themselves on all the spikes and it's not a big deal. Now, you can make it possible. I've seen a lot of people do it. You can throw out thousands of spikes so that you never have to worry about zombies again. The pictures look incredibly funny because it's thousands and thousands and thousands of spikes. And it's like, how much time did you spend doing that? That's insane. Oh, that's so incredibly funny. But yeah, guys, and too, all the feedback on the last video was absolutely amazing. I'm going to try to do less editing. I do want to cut out some of the boring parts. I mean, like the running from one city to the other when I wasn't doing anything but running and a little bit of scouting wasn't too bad. But with more exploring, more gathering, we're definitely going to find more areas. I can't wait to get to building my main base, because then the content's going to be a lot easier. You guys can watch me build, do what I do best on survival, and that's building. I am planning on doing a creative Let's Play. Now, I never did creative on Minecraft because I love survival building, but unfortunately in 7 Days to Die, you have limited block availability in survival, and I do like to build massive things, and unfortunately the only way I can access all the blocks in the game is to go through survival. So yeah, guys, you'll be seeing a survival playthrough, but it's going to be a creative playthrough where I build something massive. My friend Fluffy Maniac, actually, I think I might invite him. We might do the mall from I forget the name of the movie. Not Night of the Living Dead. Wow. It's a zombie movie where everyone's in the mall. They get trapped in the mall and they survive in it. Shamefully, I can't remember the name off of it off the top of my head. I just rewatched it the other night too, just to get pumped about it, because I love zombie movies. So that's what I love about this game too, is you can play this game any way you want, Walking Dead style, 28 days, 28 days later style, that type of thing, right? Like, it's all up to you. And I've seen a lot of people bashing people for the way they want to do their playthroughs. Like, there's one guy that commented on the video that he liked doing the Walking Dead playthrough because instead of building a fort and hiding on the roof at nighttime, he likes to stand out on the road and just take on the zombies because they can't run at you, right? So you can stand in the middle of the road and shoot them, which is really cool. I can appreciate that. And then we had some other guy reply that, you know, he was a pussy for doing that. And I don't necessarily think so. It's your game. It's your playthrough. Do it the way you want, right? But yeah, let's keep banging trees here. And I'm actually going to head back because those iron bars should be finished by now. But I'm going to continue looting on my way back. where did my bank go? There we are. That's so useful if you use the mini map to get back to your base with your bed. because waypoints are cool, but once you have a few waypoints, they kind of clog up your compass, and you can't exactly see where you're going. But let's head back to the base here and get those iron bars up on the side. Wow, look at all the zombies. Remember how I told you guys I jacked the zombie spawning? That is why you're seeing so many zombies. That's how I balanced it out myself, right? Like, low zombies and walking zombies for me would be too easy. So I didn't want to ruin the game by putting them walking and having, like, a low zombie count. So I just jacked it. That's how I balanced it. Let me know down in the comments what your guys' favorite way of playing the game is. I love playstyles. There's quite a few out there. Maybe even a few that I don't know. I bet there is. So let me know down in the comments, guys, how you do your playthroughs. I'd love to hear about them. Ooh, make sure I hit up these nests. Get myself some more wood. Man, these tool skills are going to take forever to load up. Because I haven't started building a base yet. But unfortunately, I don't want to build a base until I got like cement and tool and steel smithing and all that stuff going, because I don't like bothering with the cobblestone upgrading from wood. Upgrading from wood frames to concrete frame or steel frames is incredibly expensive. It's way more expensive than just putting a rebar frame down, making a concrete block, and then upgrading it to steel. Let's go around this bear here. They're not known to be very friendly. The bear spawning on console is really freaking weird too, guys. They're not nearly supposed to spawn that much. I don't know why they do, but it is what it is. Hopefully they fix that. I'm thinking it's a glitch because on PC, bears didn't spawn nearly that much and they weren't nearly as aggressive. I have never died from a bear on PC in the 800 hours I played it. But within the first 3 hours of playing console, I died three or four times from bears. It was just, I spawned literally on top of one at one point. I couldn't believe it. So I'm thinking the bear thing's just a glitch, guys. But they do have good news too. I've seen that they have about 200 bug fixes coming up for console. So hopefully we'll see that patch coming up here very soon and bring us a little bit of a more stable game. I mean, after the last update too, I find the frame rate drop isn't that bad anymore. It's not nearly as often as it used to be, and it's not nearly as long. I've just learned how to adapt with it, right? Like, I don't get myself stuck in a corner with a bunch of zombies. I always make sure there's space between me and the zombies so I can hit them with a bow or a ranged weapon. It's just stuff you have to use as common sense, guys. If this was a real world, would you take on a zombie horde hand-to-hand? I know they do in The Walking Dead, but it's multiple people, right? Did I not loot these guys? Maybe we had another horde coming along. Weird. I'm going to re-loot them anyways. I don't need that stuff quite yet. Nothing good. Hey, nurse. Headshot. Once again, why I love the bow. I just wish they leveled a lot better. Like, nothing good. Okay, let's loot this guy here who's hanging out in a spot. Oh, ouch. Okay, Skippy, stop. Oh, and if you guys are lagging onto the spikes too, I've seen that as a complaint. Like, I'm placing down spikes and I keep lagging into them. Guys, what are you doing so close to your spikes that you lag into them? Like, you can be three blocks away to lay spikes down, just like this. Here we are. Like, look at this. One. Oops. If I can look at it. Two, three. You don't have to stand next to the spike and place it. That's how you're going to catch yourself. Yeah, silly darks. But anyways, let's go back up top, guys, and get some of those frames placed down so that the day 14 horde won't be nearly as bad. And then, okay, and I'm bleeding out. Let's not die, Skippy. Let's not die here. I got to get my health up. Wow, I am sloppy this episode. So sloppy. I'm trying to get all my trophies for living long. I've gotten all the way up. Actually, the last episode, I got the 500-minute one, I believe. And I'm working my way up to the 1250-minute one. So, I mean, that's not too bad, right? Oh. May as well get rid of this. Just a chest full of... Yeah, I'm going to get rid of this one here, too. Cool. Let's see how our forge is going. I'm also going to turn that off, too, so we don't get much screamer attention. Nice. We got our iron bars going on. So this is a little risque. Thankfully, I don't have too many spikes around the area. Let's heal up a little bit more before I attempt this. Now, there is no crouch function in this game, so you can't like simply crouch around an edge, but if you're careful enough, you can look around the edge easy enough and get around that. So I'm going to stash some of this stuff I don't need quite at this moment. Before I do this... Ooh, and get some food going here. Definitely get some food going. Always make my food right away. And I'm going to do some eats here too, so that... Nice, there we are. Oh, that was a perfect balance. I had just enough meat and just enough eggs, and I didn't have to put any in the inventory. Oh, nice. I'm at 117. And I also want to get the trophy too for having my health jacked all the way up. The only trophies I see that are absolutely insane in the game are the PvP trophies, where you have to kill 2,500 people. But honestly, oops, that was not water. But honestly, guys, if you really want to do it, just bring your friend into a game and you both place sleeping bags down and just keep killing each other. I think that's the only way you can do it. I might do it with my buddy Fluffy Maniac just so we can get those trophies. That, in my opinion, is not cheating because you are killing that many people. It would be cheating if you duplicated or did something like that on survival to get weapons to do the killing. But other than that, I don't really consider that cheating at all. Ooh, this pistol's much, much better quality. Oop, if I don't drop it on the ground. So I'm going to stick this in my inventory. This is so much better. Oh, that other gun had the ammo loaded into it. Never mind. I'm going to put this away for now. And let's get those iron bars out. Nice. So, this is a tricky part here. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to go right here. Whoa, if I don't fall off. And I'm going to look at the side. I'm going to use my L2 to rotate it and get it so it's laying flat. There we are. So I can place my first couple now that I've placed those. I can actually pick up these frames because I'm not too afraid of falling off anymore. And I can place the rest. What I like doing is I like doing this all at the same time. I should put my mining helmet on so I can actually see. Here we go. Turn that light on. And yeah, since there's no crouch function, you can actually look across the sides and it's still not even that bad. Like you can go a considerable distance off the side. Now, 80 should be enough to do one row around. That's all I really plan on doing. I usually do two, but that's more of a permanent base thing. This way, the spider zombies can't get up to me at all. Here we are. But I do have to leave a space for one ladder, and what I think I might do there is just put a hatch there so that they can't get up. So let's continue doing this without falling. And if you guys watched my day 6 or 7... day 6 or 7 tutorial video where I fell off the edge because I didn't have anything running along it. I had a few people try to call me out. It was actually quite amusing. because in my tutorial videos, I try to do the noob things on purpose so that I can, you know, replicate because I did all that stuff at the beginning. Ooh, my. Okay, so I was going to take this off because it's got an angle on it and I didn't think it would be very visually appealing. But what I'm going to do is just attach it to the outside of it because anything that takes or any item takes up an entire block, no matter how big it is. If it's a quarter block, if it's a slab, it all takes up one block's worth of space. So if I place one of these on top of each other, they'd be in different block spaces, just like that. So I can still use the side of this. It just might be a little tricky getting around that edge and, Hopefully, I almost fell. Yeah, that's going to be really tricky to do. So what I'm going to do is actually go down, and I'm going to do block my way up. I really hate spraining and breaking my ankle in this game. It's horrid. But what I'm going to do is block my way up and just do it that way. It's a little bit safer. To make my way around all these spikes, trying not to kill myself with these torches. Two guys, once you get the ability, like once you start scrapping cars and stuff, start making yourself spotlights. Because on both PC and console, those torches actually cause game lag. So try to avoid having tons of torches around your bases, because that will cause you a little bit of lag too. Just as a heads up. So let's get this all finished up here. Just like that. There we go. Not so tough anymore. Alright, so now that I got that done, I'm going to just frame my way back down and go back up and finish this all off here. Stupid torches. I don't know why you can't walk through a torch. I wish you could. Kind of bumps you to the side a little bit. I think at one point in time you could actually walk through the torch. I believe I remember that. But up we go. So to make the hatch, I'm going to need springs and some iron and all that other lovely stuff. So I'm going to have to go out also and get some more cars as well. So let's get these all the way around here. And once I've got that done, guys, I'll meet up with you and we'll discuss what I'm going to do in the next episode here. Okay, cool, guys. So I got our iron bars all the way up along these lines here, and I do apologize if you guys hear any ambient noise. I do live in a split level house. I have the basement of the place and rent the upstairs. I recently the people that moved in sound like a horde of elephants sometimes, so it is kind of hard to record, which sometimes is why I do some editing, because if there's noise in the background and stuff, I just get rid of it. But I am looking at getting some office space here locally, because it's incredibly cheap actually for office space here. So I can have a nice quiet space I can go to, do some recording, maybe make a soundproof room so that my voice sounds better, because I'm in my residence right now and I got stuff running like my computer and stuff, my fridge, you know, everything makes a little a low hum, and this blue snowball mic is amazing, but the damn thing picks up every sound. But yeah, guys, that pretty much I think concludes this episode. Thanks once again, guys, for all your likes and comments, shares. Shares really do help my channel grow, guys. Even if you share your stuff to something that nobody looks at, it tells YouTube that you're so interested in my video that you want to share it with other people, and YouTube turns and suggests it to other people, saying, hey, if someone shares it, that means they love it, so we're going to show it to other people. So if you guys want the channel to grow, definitely do that. And once again, guys, next episode I think we're going to be doing some more gathering, try to get my my tool skills up here, because they desperately need to be leveled. What are we at here before I end the episode? We are at, got my construction tools up to 20. Okay. So next episode, what I might actually do is just go farm a whole ton of wood, make a whole ton of frames, and just keep upgrading stuff out somewhere random where it doesn't matter. Just get my tool levels up, because it seems to level up faster if you're building with it than as opposed to if you're farming with it or gathering materials with it. So hopefully, guys, you know, next episode here, we'll get some more done. And I'll see you guys later. Keep surviving, stay classy, and peace. We got to turn it on. We got to turn it on.